You know how Emerson said, like, if we're not changing our minds, if we're not contradicting ourselves, if we're not saying diametrically opposed things in our later life than we did in our youth, we're clearly not growing. And although there's the archetype of the wizard becoming a child again, making the sacrifices necessary for maturation and then returning to the childlike aura from whence he came, although that is an archetype, we also need to realize that we should be growing in such a way that we contradict our younger selves and yet not neglect or deny our younger selves, but accept that as part and parcel of the journey to get us to where we are now. So it's all canon. Very important. And so one of the things that when I was younger, I talked a lot about was unity. It's basically like, I remember people saying, well, is this just an, can't you all get along? Like, maybe that's not really what Ben's saying. Maybe it's hopefully more deep than that. I'm like, no, it's that simple. Why can't we all get along? But as I've gotten older, I realized, what about the people who with malintent, malevolence, and malfeasance are trying to like torture you constantly, and they literally through jealousy are out to destroy you as much as possible and eradicate and eviscerate you. Well, you want in those moments an us and them mentality. I know that it's, you know, maybe not popular to say because we don't want an us and them mentality, but what do you do when people are out to get you? If you're like, well, why can't we all just like unify and get along? It's kind of like if you have a son and then somebody beats up your son and you say, oh, well, you know, you both are loved. You both are right. Like you both are, you know, everybody's right and wrong in the same way. So I'll just love them both equally. This someone would be like, well, first of all, I'm your kid. Second of all, is their safety. Third of all, is their protection in your presence? Or are you just somebody who's like, oh, you guys, let's just all get along, even though there's a bully who just is trying to do me in. Obviously, you want a dad who says, son, I got your back. I'm going to protect you against all comers. In the same way, the people with whom I'm closest are not those who just say, I'm your ride or die. The people who actually have my back, they don't even need to say it. They're just always, like, they will kill for me. And that's something that's really helpful. And what I mean by that is not trying to like go after people, but when people are coming after me, they'd step in front of the bullet for me. They'd kill for me. And that's something I love. And these are the most kind, loving people. But man, when I love how my mom says like her name's Tambo, but when anyone comes against her family, she becomes Rambo. And there are people who just like want to attack the innocent. And that's why there's the imprecatory Psalms and the scriptures of Judaism in the Judaistic religion, specifically not quite as much in Christendom, although there is some of that there, but it's primarily in Judaism. In the Psalms, for instance, when it says that God's going to basically and effectively and essentially protect those who are going against his beloved. And so that's really helpful. And he's like going to kick the teeth in of the enemies. Like, won't you kick their teeth in kind of thing. So my goal is like, I want to, there's this great line in Christendom where it says, as much as up to you, make peace with all men. And obviously I pull from this stuff because I come out of the world of Christianity. That's my past. But what I'm saying is I love the idea of saying, I want to make peace with everybody. But when people are coming against me, I'm so glad to know there are those who have my back, and it's like an us and them mentality. So it's this loving, unifying alacrity and eagerness that you're willing to give it out. But you realize if somebody's going against your beloved, in the same way that like if somebody came against Fridge, I would smash them. Like, you know what I mean? I would not let it happen because I'd get Fridge's back. I wouldn't just say, oh, it's okay. You know, like, it's not a good thing that you're doing to Fridge, my cat, but I'm just going to, you know, why can't we all get along? It's like Fridge would look at me and say, are you going to protect me? And I'm so thankful that there are those in my life who are willing to get my back, who are protecting me, and I would do the same for them. And that's, I know it might sound like tribalism, but that's because there are people who are stuck in a tribalistic mindset or coming to attack you, even though our desire is for peace. And that's why Taoism says that the worst tool for the wise understand that the worst tools, the least valuable tools are weapons, but they only take them up in a last resort. And that's why if people are coming against us tribalistically, our tribe will get together and use those weapons to protect us, to get our back. And I absolutely am enamored of that idea.